Hey Wayne, we gotta lift this table and make sure it's under capacity for this crane and the straps. Can you help me with that?
I sure can. We'll have to take some dimensions and figure out what we need to do, make sure it's under the capacity. All right, Austin. So in order to figure out the weight of this, we're gonna have to first determine how much of each material we need. Then we're gonna reflect back into this Ryerson book and determine how much that material weighs per unit. And then we'll add those all up and determine what the total weight of the material is. So the first thing we're gonna start out with is this 3/8 top here. So we're gonna measure the area of that, or determine the area of that by measuring the length and the width. So we have 24 by 48, and that's 24 inches by 48 inches. So now when we do that, we're gonna go into the book and determine what that is as a weight. So if we look in here, the Ryerson book says that we have 3/8 plate equals 15.32 pounds per square foot.
So now we're gonna do the legs.
Correct, so let's take a look at the legs. So we have inch and a half by inch and a half by 1/8 inch square tube. And those are 28 inches long. And then I see we also have this cross member here that is the same material, and the length of that will be 40 inches. So we'll have 5 separate pieces.
So now we're gonna find that in the Ryerson book.
Correct.
So it looks like that square tube is gonna be 2.21 pounds a foot.
Correct.
So Wayne, we'd have to do the angle iron the same way then.
Correct. So let's determine what we have. So we have 1.5 inches by 1.5 inches by 1/8 inch angle iron, and our lengths will be 16 inches. So we're gonna have two pieces that are that size. So we'll have to go to the Ryerson book again and determine what the size and weight of those pieces are.
So that would be in the structural shape section, right?
Correct.
So it looks like it's 1.23 pounds a foot.
Correct. All right, Austin, so now we can go through some of our calculations to determine the weight of each part. So the first one we'll work on is the tabletop. It shows it here as the steel plate, 3/8 inch thick. And we determined earlier that our dimensions for the perimeter were 24 by 48, giving us a total area in square inches as 1,152 square inches.
And that 144 is the bringing it to feet, right?
Correct, because our Ryerson book determined that our weight was in pounds per square foot. When we originally came through, we came up with pounds, or we would come up with pounds per square inch. So yes, you are correct. We would divide that by 144 and determine how many square feet are in that. From there, then we would go to the square tubing. So the square tubing that we have here, those are the legs that are on here, and then also the cross member that's there. And we determined that we had 4 of them at 28 inches, and 1 at 40 inches, giving us a total linear length of 152 inches. And there's 12 inches in a foot. Our Ryerson book again told us that we had pounds per foot, so originally we come up with inches, so now we have to convert that by dividing by 12, giving us 12 2/3 feet. And lastly, we have the angle iron. So with that, we came up with the angle iron being two pieces at 16 inches, giving us a total of 32 inches. And again, the Ryerson book talked about it being in pounds per foot. So we had to divide it by 12, giving us 2 2/3 feet. From there, then we have to multiply those feet calculations or units by the weights of the Ryerson book, giving us the weights that we have there for each individual part. Last thing we'd have to do is then add them together, giving us a total weight of the table at 153.8 pounds.
So this is our sling. How do we know what that's rated for?
All right, Austin, we can take a look at the tag, and the tag is going to determine how much we can lift with this and determine the capacity. So it tells us right here that we have a 500 pound capacity on this strap. So based on our calculations, we should be safe to be able to lift with this strap. So now we can go ahead and put it around it and hook it up.
Gotcha. That's sure is a lot of math to know if you're safe to lift something.
It sure is, Austin, but the consequences if we overrate the crane or the straps are pretty substantial, and there is a definite chance somebody can get hurt with that.
I guess it's better to be safe than sorry.
That is correct.